Hi, my name is Dan Garcia. I'm a teaching professor at UC Berkeley. I'm very excited to tell you about our project funded by the Governor's Office of Planning and Research and the California Education Learning Lab, whose title you see on the right. This is a collaboration among five faculty: Solomon Russell, Edwin Ambrosio, Armando Fox, myself, and Álvaro Monge at El Camino College, UC Berkeley, and CSU Long Beach. The big idea: learning as it usually happens in classrooms all around the world. Students come in with various aptitude levels. There's a bell curve: students at the top, students at the bottom, students in the middle. At the end, the achievement is A through F grades. It's also a bell curve. Students get grades at the top, and students get grades in the middle, and students get grades at the bottom. So the mantra there is there's a fixed time, but variable learning. You still got students getting D's and F's. You do as much as you can, but you still got D's and F students. And that's really a challenge for trying to achieve equity goals. You might have students from under-resourced backgrounds who don't come in with the preparation that students at very wealthy schools might have. How do we support those students? Well, we've known this for 50 years. The model is mastery learning. Benjamin Bloom, in 1968, came up with the idea, which is you can't move on to later material unless you've mastered the earlier material. You don't try to ride a motorcycle before you learn how to ride a bicycle really well, really, really well. If you slow down and let them work on the bicycle as long as it takes them, they'll be able to ride the motorcycle well. So that means that students, if you just give them enough time, could actually learn the material and do very well if they give enough time. The new mantra now is fixed learning, you know, A-level learning, variable time. Give the students as long as they need to master that material. So how do we get there? You know, here's a model on the right of, you know, one-on-one or one-on-two instruction. I got 1,000 students in my class. I certainly don't have 1,000 faculty co-teaching the class with me. So how does that actually work? Well, let me introduce you to five colleagues from the University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign. This is Craig, Matt, David, Carlene, and Patrick. And they've written a system called Prairie Learn. The idea is you author in software rich question generators. The picture on the left is structural analysis, and they're measuring shear, and they're evaluating the student who needs to draw pictures to evaluate shear and moment diagrams. On the right, it's a CPU data path, and you're putting in the values of the CPU signals at any level. On the top left, you're seeing a picture of graphing a piecewise quadratic curve. On the top right is maybe looking at the center of a mass of an object, and the bottom is a picture of simplifying a Boolean circuit in computer architecture. The idea is any one of these can be used either for formative assessment, which is homework, or summative assessment, which is exams. You can let them practice as much as they want, and then you can have exams at the end of the day that the same system can deliver the homework and can deliver the exams. And because it's software, you can have random generation. So here's an exam that I offered my students this fall 2020 semester in Intro to Computer Science class, in which every student got basically a different exam. And here's an exam, here's a question in which I'm asking them to draw a fractal, to author the computer code to write a fractal. So I give them the picture and they have to write code to generate the picture. But this is a picture one student got, and that's the picture the next student got, and that's the picture the next student got. And each of these students are getting a different problem. They're all exactly hard, equally hard, but each one is getting a different problem. So trying to cheat doesn't make any sense because my solution doesn't work for your particular problem. It's really a way to have institutional resilience as we have online learning. There's a huge pedagogical benefit to students. If you see in brown, if you have fewer high-stakes assessments, like a big midterm and a big final, well, what do you get? You get a lot of Fs and Ds and not as many As. But if you have, and this is research from University of Illinois Urbana-Champaign, they've said, well, what if we had exams, more frequent exams, but lower stakes exams. So more frequent, lower stakes exams. And if you look at the F, D, and F curve, basically that became the group of A's. So not to say they moved, but they all shifted up so that now we have a ton of A's and far fewer D's and F's. Huge benefits. So overall, the project is for the high demand STEM courses in computer science and data science at our institutions, we're going to build and deploy question generators for those courses. We're going to evaluate their effectiveness toward mastery learning. This involves 19 faculty, many grad students, and many undergrads. The impact potentially is 3,300 students. Learner success. We've seen master learning really works. It's been proven in research. Student equity. Students can take as long as they want to working on those problems until they actually get mastery and move on. And institutional resilience. You have this kind of the curbing online cheating in a remote online scenario really, really does help institutional resilience as well. Finally, all work is available as an open education resource, and we'd like to thank the California Education Learning Lab for our funding. We're very much excited for this project. Thank you so much.